Hey everybody, I just wanted to let you know we're supposed to get a big winter storm tomorrow. And as you can see, my tablet's going off. My tablet's going off because we're under both the winter weather advisory and a winter storm watch. So I'm gonna shut it down because I don't, because this. Okay, it's off. So I don't want to end up. So my tablet went off too, and I want to make sure I could hear it. So I got it set to a continuous siren, which I downloaded. In fact, I put the app on my phone. Yeah, my tablet yesterday. In fact, because I kind of knew that it would be bad. I just didn't know where. But as you see, my weather radios did not go off because they don't go off for winter storm watches. Only winter storm warnings. So as you can see, none of the weather radios went off. But we're supposed to get 5 to 7 inches of rain, or not rain, but snow. 5 to 7 inches, but they're not supposed to, but it's gonna be around freezing marks, so that means there's a chance the snow will be heavy and wet, making it even more heavier to plow if we need to and stuff. See, as you see, none of my weather radios went off because they do not sound during a winter storm watch. They only sound for warnings. See? So I better put this up. There we go. But as you see, we're not under a warning yet. See, otherwise these would have been going off. But we are under the winter storm watch plus a winter weather advisory. The winter weather advisory is calling for some snow and strong winds. So, they're not strong winds, but there is a chance the winds will be strong, in other words. But, and ice accumulation of a tenth of an inch. As you see, I am already prepared. I got the plow on my tractor, plus I got the snowblower. And the snowblower does run because I tested it when I got from the back shed to the garage. I used the self-propelled, so I know it works and stuff. So, yep. But right now, it's only Tuesday. Or it's Tuesday, December 13th, 2022. And the storm isn't forecasted to hit until starting later tonight. And the big stuff, though, is supposed to hit tomorrow, where it says heavy snow, 5 to 7 inches. But as you see, the trees are moving a little bit. It's hard to see because the leaves are already off. So, but if you look, the trees are moving a little bit. But as you see, and it's very cold. It's pretty chilly out. So, yeah. So, we zoom out. There we go. But. I just want to let you know I am prepared for the winter storm tomorrow, where we could get 5 to 7 inches of snow where we are and stuff. And it doesn't say it on a weather alert, but if we get, because it's going to be below freezing this weekend, it's going to, like in the 20s, it's going to only be, it means the snow and ice will stay longer than if it were in the 30, let's say 37 or 40, then it would have been melted already. But it's supposed to be in the 20s this weekend, which will make the snow and rain, or snow and ice stick. And it could also put stress on the tree limbs, especially trees that don't lose their pine needles like pine trees do. and stuff. So because we're both to get snow plus ice plus wind. So some branches may break off, but even though it doesn't say that, there's always a chance it will, especially pine trees. But right now, it is, the temperature outside is 33, so it's 1 degree above freezing. And I kind of feel it because of the wind and stuff. The wind chill. But as you see, it's 33 degrees. And if they issue a warning for our area and all the weather radios sound off, I will make a video on it. And as you see by my decorations for Christmas, you can see the wind is making them move. See? The wind are making them move, so that shows it's a little bit of gusty winds we have right now. But we're supposed to get wind as the storm comes. So if there was any snow and ice that accumulate on the trees and power lines, we'll put extra strain on them with the, and the wind will could make a break off. Some of those, not maybe the bigger branches, but the little wider ones might come off. Especially pine trees, because they don't ever lose their leaves. And stuff. So I'm going to get my shoes on. I'll take you outside so you can see the what I'm talking about. So I'll put it all in the general room. Not trying to be messy, but it's true.
No, just until after Christmas.
Yeah.
Then it'll be taken all down the basement.
Until next year.
So. But yeah, if you could check that one, that would be
great. Yeah, I will. Yeah, we got a package. Oh, yeah. Let's come down the ramp. As you see, we did lose some tree limbs, but those were a while ago when we had some strong winds come through. That's why it's all messy. I don't think it's from this wind, the gusty wind we're getting now, but yeah, but you could tell it's pretty windy. There's right now nothing happening other than some gusty winds a little bit. But as you see, we lost some stuff out of our trash can. It's probably when we had that gusty winds today, because before the winds came, it was all closed like that. But yeah, so I'm trying to pick this up so it doesn't blow into the neighbor's yard. So, and what earlier when I said about pine trees that could break, well, here's what I'm talking about. I take care of this guy's lawn here. And right now, you can see the wind more on the pine trees here though. Because you could see the pine needles and branches starting to move a little bit. But as you see, we don't have an ounce of snow on the ground yet. But that will eventually change. That's why we're under a winter storm watch, which if we're under any alert, like advisory or watch, we have to take it a little seriously, especially watches and warnings. That when they issue a winter storm watch, then you know it's coming. And a warning means it's on its way, getting closer and closer. But as you can see, pine needles are moving, branches are moving, but nothing happening yet. But I'm over it. But yeah, see, these are the pine trees I was talking about. But regular trees like this one, this dead one right here that could come down. But this dead one could come down from the snow too, because it's completely dead. You can see the barks off it. And there's a pretty good gust of wind. But we already had a branch come off this one way up there. Let me zoom in. See right up there? See how it's dead? You can tell it's rotted. That came off from the June 15th, 2022 storm. The one that produced a tornado in West Bloomfield. And by Seymour there. And it also, the wind came through here and broke this big tree limb off. So that proves this tree here is rotted and could come down if a lot of weight is exposed. So, yep. And the pine trees, of course, they can take more strain before breaking. But we've already had winter storms come through here. And then I go over here again afterwards and there's a branch laying on the ground. So, we've had pine trees branches come down, but right now nothing yet. Like in here, we had a big tree, half of this tree came down back in 2018 when we had that bad winter storm in April. This tree came down, as you see right there, and it covered this whole thing. So that proves even trees that lose their leaves by now, and before they grow them, and if we get a winter storm, they can break. But the amazing thing is, this tree didn't come down until after the storm, so it must have been a weekend. Because, so I had to come over here and clean it up. So it took me weeks or even months to clean that branch up. And it wasn't until a couple years ago that I was able to get a car over here and pull that out. But that proves that winter storms can do a lot of damage. Like collapsing, if it's heavy enough, collapsing roofs, stuff like that. So, yep. If you look down there, and by the way, I have my camera on Zoom. But, yeah. And I was actually, when they issued the watch for our area, it actually, I was outside, or I was in the living room wrapping gifts because it's almost Christmas. And I went in and checked the weather. And I went in my room and I heard the sirens going off on my tablet, as you heard in the beginning of the video. And that's how I knew we were under a winter storm watch, because in the app it says winter storm severe, and when it says severe, you know it means it's a watch or a warning have been issued. If it says winter storm strong, that means it's an advisory or statement. And that's how I know. But we are both under a winter storm or winter weather advisory plus a winter storm watch. So, and I kind of had a feeling that this, we would be issued one because for our area, because at first it was only in northern Wisconsin where they issued the watch, but then this morning I checked it and it expanded directly east, and I knew it would be a matter of time before they issued one for our location. And sure enough, that's when the storm, that's when I found out they issued a storm for the whole county of Waupaca where we live, and including King, because King is part of the watch too. So yeah, so Right now, all that we are getting is some wind, but nothing severe yet. No snow, nothing. That's going to come probably later tonight and definitely tomorrow and Thursday. And Friday, you'll notice it start clearing up and stuff. But like I said, I have already had the snowblower in the garage and also the I also have the snowblade on my tractor, so I can either use a snowblower or a blade. So yep. And like I said in the beginning of the video, we got a package, probably a Christmas gift for somebody, I'm guessing, because Christmas is right around the corner. So yep. So I have to get going, but if they issue an alert and our weather radios go off, I'll make a video on it. So yep. Bye everybody. Hi everybody. I just want to let you know that around 3 a.m. this morning, the National Weather Service issued a winter storm warning for our area. So they're saying like 7 to 10 inches of snow now. But as you see, the weather radios did go off, but that was just for the weekly test, not the winter storm warning and stuff. The weekly test was today, because today is Wednesday and stuff like that. So, but yeah, so the weather radios did sound off only for the weekly test though. So I'm gonna come outside. Right now it's raining. It was raining basically all morning and early afternoon. And it's still raining. It's still raining. And it was raining earlier this morning when I woke up too. See? You see the ramp all wet. And there are some twigs down, but that was from a wind a few weeks ago. Like in November. We had some wind that took down some twigs, but nothing. But there may be some mixed in from the gusty winds we had today. But yeah, as you see, right now it's not snowing yet. It's raining instead. But as you see, there's a big puddle right here. And you can see, if I go close enough, you can see the rain hitting the rain making little waves in it. So it shows it is still raining. And as you see, I have my jacket on because it is a little chilly out now. And I have the hood on to stop me from getting too wet. So yeah. So I'll put it on rear camera so you can see ahead where I'm seeing. See, as you see, right now, there's no snow actually. It's actually too warm to have really any accumulation. Just scattered snow showers in areas. The big stuff is supposed to hit after midnight. So early tomorrow morning, it's going to be, when I wake up tomorrow, there's probably going to be a lot of snow on the ground that I probably need a plow. But as you've seen from yesterday, I did the first clip. I showed you that I'm ready for the storm to hit. Because, and they said, yeah, it's going to start out as rain, but then transition to snow overnight. So right now there's no snow on the ground, not a single ounce of snow on the ground yet. But northern Wisconsin by the Northwoods, they're probably have a little bit of snow coming down because it's always colder up there versus here. So the snow is going to hit us around early AM hours. So like anywhere after 12 midnight, it's going to start. And like I said, the weather radios did go off, but that was just for the weekly test, not the alert, not the warning for us. The warning, they didn't go off because I don't think they go off for warnings in the night hours, just in daytime and stuff. But as you see, I'm in our backyard right now. And we do have some branches down here in by the neighbor's yard. As you can see, some sticks and stuff. But nothing really, no big branches. But if we get a heavy snow like you're talking, that's when we're gonna start seeing probably problems with trees starting to bend over because of the weight of the snow. But it is gonna be heavy and wet. Unlike the, when it's too cold, it'll be only fluffy snow that won't really accumulate much on trees. But we're supposed to get the wet snow that stays on the trees, and it'll stay there because starting Friday, it's supposed to be cold. Friday through all next week, basically, it's going to be only in the 20s and upper teens, low 20s for a high. Typical December weather where we live, because I live in Waupaca, Wisconsin, so it's always Wisconsin winter is always colder, and summers are medium to high. So we get, in Wisconsin, the winter storm is named Winter Storm Axel. They named it about a day ago. So that would have been yesterday morning, I think. But as you see, they said that it's going to be warm enough that it's all going to be rain. But we did get some ice. We did get some ice earlier today and stuff. But most of it's melted right now. But there is still some patches. So I'm still going to salt just to be careful. See right here, some ice and stuff. So yeah, we have some ice here. That probably, because we may have got a little bit of freezing rain last night, but not enough to do any accumulation on trees. Like the worst ice was forecast to stay in Minnesota, where we would get some ice, but they would get significant ice in Minnesota. Left them to check the news, but as you see. So all we're getting is some little bit of wind and some heavy rain, or some rain, not really heavy rain, but just regular rain. It's right now it's sprinkling a little bit or misting, but it'll probably during the night hours it'll be cold enough where it'll transition to snow. And it's going to be still warm enough that it could be heavy and wet. So when you think of heavy, wet snow, sometimes the weight can break tree limbs. Because all heavy, wet snow is has a lot of water vapor, a lot of water inside it that creates heavy. You know how you try to build a snowman? You use the wet snow to build a snowman. You know how heavy it is? That's the way it is on trees, too. And when they're trying to plow by hand, too. So, that's where we're forecasted to get. And stuff. But, right now there's nothing happening yet. Just rain. And a little bit of wind. But as you see, I did cover my dad's 68 Impala up, and I made sure I got the tires over there off the driveway so I could plow without hitting anything. And there used to be a chair over here and a spare tire. I put the spare tire in the garage and I put the chair over here. So I still can plow without hitting anything and stuff. And then the trailer is right here, which is good because if we get a lot of snow, what I'll probably have to do is go to go to another place to do some plowing too, if the snow is deep enough. Because with it being colder, it's probably going to stick, because the weekend won't help at all either, and next week, because it should be only in the teens and 20s for a high. So right now it's kind of mild, but it's still, I can feel the chill in the air. Like, it's probably in the mid to upper 30s maybe right now. But like I said in the beginning of this part, that there is a winter storm warning out for our area. So all the way from central Wisconsin, which includes Waupaca, all the way north is under a winter storm warning, while areas to the south are under a winter weather advisory only. That means they probably won't get as much snow down there as they do as we're going to get during the warned area. But yeah, and I do forgot to mention in the first part, but I do have a electric power shovel, so I can plow this pretty easy. And then what I can't get with the power shovel, I got this manual shovel that I brought up, so it's right there, so I'm able to use it. And I also, yesterday, that was before all the rain started. Before the rain started, which was yesterday, I tipped the trailers upward. That'll allow snow to run off and water, because gravity will bring it all out of there. But yeah, so like I said, as the storm gets closer, which will probably be around 11 or 12, I'll make a video on it. Probably around 10:30, 11, I'll make the video. But that's all. And then after the aftermath of the storm, the winter storm, that's when I'm going to make the video on that. And let's turn on the lights here. And with the heavy wet snow, they're worrying about too much weight on the tree branches falling and taking out power lines. So I did, just in case it were to happen, I put the generator to and in behind right inside the shed, so I can grab it if we need it in emergencies. And I did get this working. It's a electronic handheld sprayer, see? And then you can also lock it. So there you go. See, it's locked, so I don't have to hold the trigger and stuff. So, and you can also adjust it from there. But yeah, so that's going to be good for the ice and stuff, which I'm going to do probably later tonight to get it so no one slips. Because it is warm enough where the salt I'm going to put down will take effect. But if, I can't do it probably when it's in the 15, in the teens or the 20s, because it won't do anything and stuff. So, yeah, so this is the part 2 clip, basically. But like I said, after all the clips are done, I'm going to merge them into one video, so you guys don't have to worry about watching different videos. Keep clicking on different clips. It'll all be one. So, yep. So, I'll see you in the next video. Okay, thanks for watching. Hi, everybody. I just wanted to give you an update on the winter storm that's coming in our area. Right now, it's snowing pretty heavy, but it's only supposed to get heavier at midnight and after. The storm's not nearly halfway done yet. It just came. As you can see, my tracks in the snow. See, I can see it sticking to my boots a little bit. That means it's wet. Fluffy snow doesn't stick to your boots as much. But it's warm enough that the snow is becoming wet and heavy, which is the type of snow that takes down, which could take down some branches and power lines. But as you see, there is some snow accumulation on there, but nothing very substantial yet because the snow just started. But as you see already, the snow is coming down so heavy now that in about an hour, basically all of our driveway is covered in snow right now. Like right now it's kind of more like a dusting, but it'll keep accumulating and accumulating until it's quite a bit more snow. And there's right now it's just snowing pretty heavy right now, and the flakes, the snowflakes are pretty big. If you see those white streaks going past my camera, that's the snow. See how big the snowflakes are? Because all those streaks are snowflakes. And they're pretty good size. And as you see, I got my camera tilted a little bit upward because I don't want the snow to come on my lens as much. But as you see, the snow is just going to keep getting heavier and heavier as the night progresses into early tomorrow morning after midnight. But as you see, and we are still under a winter storm warning for heavy snow, and then they added that the weight of the snow could bring down branches and power lines. So you can tell how big the streaks are. Right now I don't see much of accumulation on any trees right now, just like a dusting on the trees, but nothing that would be enough to break a branch or anything. But it's mainly the pine trees that you notice a lot of snow on. As you see, you can see start seeing some over here. As you see up there, there's some accumulation, but you can tell how, as you see by my coat, I'm covered in snow flakes because it's already accumulated enough to cover the road and our driveway. When it does it that fast, then you know it's gonna hit. You know it's gonna be bad, because usually if it's just a regular, like, we get Alberta clippers from Alberta, Canada, usually they're out in the same day. The Alberta clipper hits us and then it's out the same day. This storm is not that case. This storm is gonna last for a couple days yet. We'll be feeling the effects way into Friday, and it's only Wednesday night. So, yeah. You can see the streaks coming down, and the road and our driveway is all covered in snow already. The box of Dad's truck is also covered in snow. And the grass, you still can see some grass, because the snow isn't that deep yet, but it is deep enough to cover the whole driveway. So it's a good thing I moved the chair, spare tire, earlier today and covered my dad's Impala, because I knew there's snow. As you see, the snow is starting to accumulate on my car, but as you see, it's not falling off. That's because it's wet, so it sticks to stuff, and that's what brings down trees and power lines. But since Dad's vehicle's cold, and so is this vehicle, it's allowing the snow to stick to that. As you can see, the snow is not falling off. And that's why a lot of trees come down in this type of snow, because there's a lot of tree branches anyway. But that's why it comes down in this much snow. And they said it's going to be heavy at times. As you see, you can see it coming by. Yeah, this storm is not nearly done yet. But anyway, yeah, the snow is wet and heavy. I can tell because as you see, my tracks I made as I came out are getting covered in snow already. That's how much snow is coming down. And it's pretty windy out now, as you see the willows moving a little bit. And see, I can put my hand right here And look, because it's so wet, it actually holds my fingerprints. Unlike fluffy snow where it would collapse, wet snow won't do that. Wet snow is water vapor in the snow, and that's what makes it stick to stuff. Normally, fluffy snow just rolls right off. Maybe a little minor accumulation of trees, but wet snow sticks like glue, basically. It keeps piling and piling until the tree branch can't withstand it anymore and breaks. I've already lost the cut right over across the street where I just took you. I already have had to clean up branches that were pretty good size from the tree because the wet snow took them down. So I'm getting used to it by now. If we get a lot of wet snow like they're forecasting, trees, possibly power outages could come out. So, yep. So just thought I would let you know, give you an update that the snow started. All right, bye everybody. Hi everybody. The snow is coming down very heavy and the wind is picking up. As you see, I don't know if you see it beyond the snow, but the wind is picking up pretty good. And the snow, this is how much snow we got. This is my generator shelter where I would park my generator when it's snowing or raining. See, it's, put my hand all the way down, see? That's how bad it is. And it's so packy that putting my hands like this doesn't even move it. So that's pretty, and I can, and another way to tell if this is wet, here for the cracking or the compressing, because regular snow doesn't do that. But like I said, and because I'm out here after dark, I have my flashlight on my phone so you can see the snow better. That's what those lines are. You probably heard me say that in the last clip. And as you see, you can hear kind of the compressing. That's the snow getting compressed when I'm walking on it. And see, this is how much we got, a lot on the cars now. Before the snow came, I put the tarp over my dad's Impala, 68 Impala. So as you see, when I move, you see it clumps together. Another indication this is wet snow versus dry snow wouldn't do that. It would just blow a little bit. That's it. As you see, even though it's pretty breezy out, the snow is not even moving, which indicates it's also wet. See? And it is currently in the morning hours, 12:35 a.m. Thursday. And I got, so cars can see me, I got the flashlight out of my phone on, so at least somebody would be able to see me. Cause see, that's all those streaks going by the camera, that's snow. It doesn't pick, and you could tell the big snowflakes and stuff, so. And now the grass is basically covered. Before and I did it, you still could see some grass. And the trees over here are now starting to get covered a little bit. Yeah, they are. See, on Tuesday, before everything started, as you see, I don't know if you see that, but there's snow on the limbs and stuff. So, yep. So, as you can see how it is, and then and stuff. Right now there's no trees bending out under the weight, but with heavy wet snow, even the wind won't make it knock over. See, and you can kind of hear, see how it moves in the clumps? That means it's wet. Fluffy snow or dry snow wouldn't do anything. But yeah, it's some gusty winds at times, but I don't see the snow bending any trees across the road, but I'll check again tomorrow through when it gets daylight, so maybe around 8, 9 tomorrow this morning, because technically it is this morning. And as you see, so we'll see how much snow we get, because it's still snowing pretty heavy. As you see, you can hear the crunching of the snow, and see how it's clumping together. That means it's wet. Only wet snow clumps together. Well, dry snow does not. Dry snow is snow that... dry snow is snow that forms when it's in the 20s and below. When the snow is unable to melt, it'll become dry. Because since it's warmer out now, the snow inside is melting, then creating a lot of water inside the snowflakes, which indicate snow. Which indicates wet snow. So, I'll let you go. And, we're getting more snow. And we're probably going to get some snow coming basically the rest of the week, too. But by Friday, it'll be basically snow showers. But we're still under the winter storm warning until 9 today. So about 9 more hours. Because it is technically 12. So, alright, I have to get going. And the next video you'll see will be when it's daylight out, so I can see what it is. Because if you look out the door, if you look out the door, see, it's still snowing. I don't think the worst of the storm is going to hit. It's going to keep accumulating all night. It's going to keep accumulating all night to do it. So we're going to have to I'll probably do some plowing when I get up. I don't want to disturb the neighbors, so it'd probably be 10 o'clock, 11 and stuff. We'll see how heavy the snow is tomorrow around that time. Because there's no showers. Hi, everybody. We got a lot of snow outside now. It is currently 6:24 in the morning. And I'm going to show you. See? And it's still snowing a little bit. And see, it's right here is how much snow we got. See? And the snow's still coming down. And the snowplows just went by on the road plowing it. And I seen the snowplows also plowing out the high school. As you see it, it is wet. This had to be about 5 inches, it looks like, by the way it is. Yeah, it has to be about 5 inches. And see, snow's piling. That shows how wet it is. Snow's piling on our willow. It's like little snowbanks on our willow. And you see it's really close to the ground, which is unusual for a willow. See, it's really close to the ground. Shows how heavy the snow is. Before, when I did the video earlier today, nothing happened. It was just accumulating a little bit on the trees. So if the willow is bending, imagine what the pine trees are. Even though the willow lost all of its leaves, the only thing they were buying, but it still was a a kind of a snow magnet for wet snow. See, it's really low to the ground and stuff. And as you see, this is how heavy the snow is. See, I can make snowballs with it. And then I'm going over across the street, and if you see, it's still snowing. See, right here's a snowbank that was left after the guys plowed the road. See, the guys plowed the road, and I'll have to do some plowing myself, too. Just looking. See, if you're looking. So, see, all those trees are pretty low to the ground, which, you know, has to be heavy for that to happen. And then I'm going to go over here. This is where I took the video as the snow was getting heavier and heavier. See? It's up to my ankles now. See? So, yeah. This is how heavy the snow is. It's pushing branches to the ground. And if you heard that, that was a plow going by on this road now. See, and you see how heavy the snow is. See? Pulling the branches to the ground. And stuff, see? This is how heavy the snow is. It's probably 5 inches, not more. So see, it's pulling the branches to the ground. See if there's any broken branches, which I don't see any, but yeah, so as you see, the branches are very low to the ground. See? So see? Well, yeah. See? So we got a lot of snow. So yeah, no branches appear to break off, but like they said in the last clips, that we're gonna get some more snow until Friday. That could collect on the snow that's already on the branches. Stuff, so yeah, so yeah. So yep, the branches are actually touching the ground, which shows how heavy the snow is. So yeah, still snowing. But yeah, So, that proves how heavy the snow was. And stuff. So, yep. So, yeah, that proves how heavy the snow was. So, see? So, yeah. So, this is what it looks like the next morning. So, thanks for watching.